Greetings. Welcome to Tech Tuesday number 7. Today I'm going to talk about not a complete design in itself, but a component that I've used in a lot of my designs. Most recently, I used it in a harp that I introduced in the very first Tech Tuesday and then updated in Tech Tuesday number 5. And that's the harmonica with the staggered reed plates. And the component I'm talking about is the slider mouthpiece. For this harmonica, the integrated slider mouthpiece was actually essential, but it can also be a choice to opt for instead of a conventional mouthpiece with a slider inside it, for some very good reasons. So what it is essentially a slider and a mouthpiece in one unit, and I was inspired to look into this concept by the invention of a very clever and interesting design by Vern Smith of America. He was trying to come up with a way to play the chromatic hands-free. And in fact, he calls his invention the hands-free chromatic. And I don't know if you've ever seen any of the various contraptions built for playing chromatic harmonicas in a rack hands-free. But some of them are very, very complicated, involving lots of wires and foot pedals and all sorts of things. And Vern's invention just eliminated all that complexity and came up with a really simple and very, very effective way of playing a chromatic in a rack. Since it was introduced, it's been adopted by quite a few really good players. And one in particular, Enrico Granaffi, makes amazing use of the hands-free chromatic. In one of my earlier Tech Tuesday videos, I was describing the interfaces that are involved in a conventional chromatic harmonica slider. The best we have these days is this style here, which was pioneered by Suzuki. Basically, you've got your mouthpiece, it's got a slide channel, and then you've got the slider that moves in the mouthpiece against the front of the comb. So in terms of this particular assembly, that's basically reducing the elements down to the very minimum. But you still have two interfaces on the slider. You've got this front surface there facing you, and you've got the rear surface, which is against the comb. So both of those surfaces need to be really airtight if the slider is going to work really well. Now, what interested me about Vern Smith's hand-free chromatic was that it eliminates one of those two interfaces, because essentially it makes the mouthpiece butt right up against the comb and move against the comb surface. And that is intrinsically superior. It's bound to be more airtight. It was this intrinsic advantage that attracted me, and I decided to incorporate it in some of my own designs. But instead of using vertical movement, as in Vern's design, I came up with the same principle, but applied it to horizontal movement. The first invention that I adopted my horizontal slider mouthpiece for was the switch harp. As you can see, it's two diatonic harmonicas. And they're attached with these rear screws to a central body part. And on top of that is my moving slider mouthpiece. And this selects between them. When you move the slider, it selects between the two harps. That can be used to make a chromatic harmonica, two harps of different keys, two harps of different tunings. I mean, basically the possibilities are endless. And I made switch harps in many, many different configurations, many different brands, many different models. So here's some photos of some of the crazy switch harps I came up with. So besides eliminating an interface between your mouth and the harmonica, another good aspect of the sliding mouthpiece, certainly my versions, is that I'm able to reduce the distance between the mouth and the reeds. I can basically slim down the mouthpiece a lot by several millimeters compared to a standard chromatic mouthpiece and slider. And it's always good to get your mouth closer to the reeds. You get more control over the reeds, it eliminates any issue of Helmholtz resonance coupling. Well, when I first came out with my horizontal slider mouthpiece, some people were a bit dubious. They thought, well, surely how can you maintain clean notes, and surely you get a bit confused if the mouthpiece moves around. But, as people tried it, they found that it was actually very easy to get used to. And subsequently, I started putting it on quite a few other kinds of harmonicas. Here's one. This is a Hohner slide harp. And I've put a horizontal sliding mouthpiece on that. You can see I've slimmed down the comb a lot from the standard chromatic comb. And that's something I'll talk about in another Tech Tuesday, how I've managed to do that. But it's allowed me to put this very slim mouthpiece on the front. And the reason I did that was in order to get, a sort of a more diatonic, crisp bending sound out of a chromatic harmonica. But in the middle octave, it's fully chromatic with the slider. So, it's quite easy to get, clean chromatic notes into your playing. So one of the keys to making it work well is to basically reduce the horizontal movement as much as possible. And the way I've done that is basically to adopt a vertical slot configuration for my slider instruments. And this means the slider doesn't move as far as it would do on a conventional, cross-tune slider like that. It actually moves just quite a small distance. Here's a screenshot of one of my switch harp designs, and you can actually see the front and the back of the slider and how they work together. Now, I talk about needing small movement, but there was one exception to that, and that's this thing. This is actually a slider mouthpiece for one of my slider bass harmonicas. I made the slider bass for a number of years, and it used a metal mouthpiece with a conventional slider in the channel, like that. But at one stage, just to eliminate that interface, I tried making this ridiculously large slider mouthpiece and putting that on the front of the harmonica. So in this case, the movement would be pretty big. So you'd probably be having to move your head slightly with the mouthpiece as you moved it. It did work, but, because of the large holes and the wide movement, it wasn't nearly as useful as my small harmonicas with sliding mouthpieces. So there we go, the horizontal slider mouthpiece. And it's been quite an integral part of several of my harmonica inventions over the last few years since I taught myself CAD design. And I'm continuing to use it, and I'll show it in some other Tech Tuesday videos in the future. Talking of which, the future is going to be pushed a little bit further away because I won't be doing Tech Tuesdays for the next 2 weeks. I'm off to Klingenthal next week, several days doing an expert workshop at the SEYDEL factory in Klingenthal. And with the travel in between and all that, it's going to be really impossible really to do Tech Tuesdays next week or the following week. But I'll be back in 2 weeks' time. Okay, bye for now.